Lord, our righteousness house of prayer. Prayer call 310-418-8189.
Yeah, yeah. I'm gonna clean up what I messed up, yeah. I'm starting my life all over again, yes, sir. I'm gonna clean up what I messed up, yeah. I'm starting my life all over.
Praise the Lord, saints. This is Pastor Gloria, the prayer warrior. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Let me just pray for you. Father, I uplift everyone listening today. Father, give them their heart desire. If they're sick and afflicted, Jehovah Rapha, we believe that you are the same today as you were yesterday. Oh, Father, all those people who went through this habit with this in Las Vegas, all these people who lost their lives, comfort the family heart, Father. Give them peace, Lord, that passes all understanding. Help them to forgive, Lord Jesus. And yes, all those who are sick and afflicted in a hospital in Vegas, Lord, be with them, Father. Give them a speedy recovery, Lord. Thank you, Father God. Could have been even worse, Lord. Oh, Father God, we just thank you that you have made us the head and not the tail, Lord. There's so many hurting people out there today, Lord. Comfort their heart, Father. You came for the broken and hearted today, Lord. And, Father, we give you all the glory for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, today we're going to talk about Halloween and what it really means. And, you know, I always like to start off with Dr. Sumlin. I love the way she put things to the table. I really enjoy. I get ministered first, and then I come behind her. So I'm going to introduce Dr. Sumlin. All right, go ahead on, girl.
God bless you, Pastor. I tell you, this is an exciting time.
Yes, it is.
People say, oh, it's a horrible time. No, any time for God is an exciting time.
Amen.
Anytime there's an uprising or an incident, that's the time for God to show himself strong.
Yeah.
To allow people to see the glory of God. Because God he made us to serve and worship him. It wasn't for us to be worshiped, but it was he put a praise, a constant praise in our heart and in our mouth that we're supposed to give to him. And sometimes we use it at the football game. Sometimes we use it at the basketball game. Giving glory to the winner. But all of the glory shall be his. Amen. And the scripture said that in the end, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord. He gonna get his full glory. Hallelujah. From man and from beast. And from everything that he made, the Bible said, let everything that have breath praise ye the Lord. Amen. And we're going to start in the book of Deuteronomy, the 18th chapter.
Yeah.
And we're going to start reading at the 9th to the 12th verse and just kind of shed some light on why we talking about Halloween and why God won't. I just got through telling you that he's going to get all the glory. Nothing else supposed to get equal time and praise to God. And he says, when you begin to do these things, they begin to set aside a day for evil to have its manifestation. We know who that is. Always trying to slip around and get some glory, but it'll never work because God is the creator. And the enemy has started in these people in Ireland going around trying to get things from people.
Right.
And it was a bad time for God's people because they were using them and burning them and using their horrid face in a fire to trace in a jack-o'-lantern. And they put the candle inside. And it looks like the face of a burning Christian. And they begin to do knock on doors. And you'll explain it more and what they did if they didn't have a treat for them. And then they began to escalate. And, you know, everything tried to, what they call it, update. And so after a while, the witches start practicing witchcraft on those days. and dressed in a certain attire and have the nerve. The devil, he always trying to take something that God made.
Amen.
Now, God made cats, all colors and kinds.
Amen.
He made a black cat. He's not unlucky.
That's right.
He is a blessed creature that God made. But the witch, she gonna have to have her something God made and take and make people scared of black cats.
Yeah.
But the devil is a lie. They're beautiful creatures.
Yes, they are.
And they just like any other animal that God made. They know God. And so the scripture says, when thou art come into the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee, thou shalt not learn to do after the abomination of those nations. There shall not be found among you anyone that maketh his son or his daughter to pass through the fire,
Amen.
Or that useth divination, or an observer of times, or an enchanter, or a witch,
yes.
A charmer, or a consulter with familiar spirits,
Amen.
Or a wizard, or necromancer.
Mm-hmm.
For all that do these things are an abomination unto the Lord. And because of these abominations, the Lord thy God doeth drive them out from before them. There's more, but I'm going to stop right here and give it over to you.
Well, you know, they first start off with a turnip. And if you didn't have anything for them when they came, they will take your first livestock, whatever it is that, like your cow or your lamb. They will kill it or burn it up for, as a sacrifice. And if you didn't have that, they would take your virgin daughter, a virgin son, and use them and abuse them and burn them up and make them go through fire as a sacrifice.
Yes, yes.
During that time is celebrating the festival of the dead. And it started October 31st to November 1st, which is All Saints Day. So they had to interrupt that day. And it was just all demonic, you know, and they had dressing attires and they did divination, they did chatting, they did all kinds of things. And that was over 2,000 years ago. Now, what the devil has done, he has made it look like it was nothing wrong with it by you wearing your costumes and they say trick or treat and then you just give the kids candy. But as you notice that during time, they were starting to put poison in our apples and in our candy. And what about the man that killed the young boys that came because they stole his Halloween things that was outside? So this is a very demonic time. I didn't know no better, neither till one of the saints of the church explained it to me. It brings in all kinds of different spirits. Yeah. And you wonder why when you go home, you hear noises in your house, cracking in your house, something hitting up against things. Well, these are spirits that's in the atmosphere. Yeah. And you just said, oh, it's no big deal. It is a big deal.
Because
what if you have a child there and it can go into the weakest vessel and cause your child to act a certain way? You're not even understanding what it is. Yeah. Well, you have these kind of demonic things in your household. And, you know, please, parents, which I know a lot of you are some good parents out there, don't let your children look at these demonic TV shows, movies, because they draw different types of spirits. I used to look at all that stuff, too, and we used to always hear things cracking in our house and all kinds of stuff. But then when I started learning, I had to start applying the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
Apply the blood. Get yourself some oil. Bless it and said, Lord, change it from its corner state to the spiritual state and get you some water and do the same thing. Sprinkle it in your house. I know you may say, oh, that ain't nothing. Look, I was one of the Ghostbusters. They would call me in because they didn't know they was doing things contrary. And I had to explain it to them. Call Pastor Glory. Things is in my house. So I have to go in there and cast that thing out. That thing sometime would throw dishes down and all kinds of things. But see, no, didn't want to come out that house. But then after I taught my people how to not to allow these enemies to enter in, now it's more peace. And I said, now you know how to do it yourself. I'm not no more Ghostbuster. I'll pray for you at home. Now you know how to do it. You do it yourself. Now, I just want to go through about the lady, the runaway concubine. And this is in the book of Judges, chapter 19.
Yeah.
And the guy went and found the lady, and he stayed at her father's house some days. And finally, he left out, And then as he was coming through this city, an old man took him in because he said it was too dangerous for him. It's almost like Lot taking in these angels. So the old man, the guy who came into the house looking, and he brought his concubine. He went looking for her from afar. Now what happened was there was some Benjamin, the Benjaminites from the tribe of Benjamin. They came and they wanted the old man. They wanted the man that went into the old man's house. They wanted to take him in and have perverted sex with him, or say unnatural affection with him. I want to say it that way, just in case the children hear unnatural affection with him. That's when you out of order and you doing, you having something to do with somebody that is not of your same race, a same male, is a male together, or a woman together, like that. Or if you're doing it, even if you're not married, that's not right neither. It's called fornication and adultery. So in verse 22, and now as they were making their heart merry, behold, the men of the city, certain sons of Baal, reset the house around about and beat at the door and spoke to the master of the house and the old man, saying, bring forth the man that came into the house that we may know him. So they wanted to rape him. And anyway, and the man of the master house went out to them and said, nay, my brother, nay, pray you, do not this wickedly, seeing that this man came into my house, and do not this folly. And so anyway, they said, he said, behold, here is my daughter and handmaiden and his concubine. Then they bring out and humble them, and he took the woman that he went to go get, which was the concubine, they gave her to the people. I said, God, why would he do something like that?
My God.
So anyway, they raped her all night long. They sodomized her all night long. She died. So in the morning, he rose up in the morning. He said, woman, get up, you know. And then that's in 28. And then she didn't get up. So he laid her up on his donkey in 28. And then he went and got a knife. This is in 29. And he came into the house and took a knife and laid hold of the concubine and divided her into her bones into 12 pieces and sent it to all the coasts of Israel. So what he did, he said, I don't know who did this. And he divided the woman up in 12 pieces. Now, this is what being out of order and trying to be something that God did not create you to be. These are the things that you are subject of doing and are doing. Okay, and so he divided the woman up in 12 pieces because he had flipped out. He really loved this concubine. And when he did this, they all came and they said, what does this mean? And they prayed, the 12 Israel, the 12 tribes, they began to pray, who did such a thing? And it fell on the Benjamin, the tribe of Benjamin. Now I want you to know, Queen Esther came from the tribe of Benjamin. Mordecai, her uncle, did, and Paul did, and a lot more. And so the reason why they didn't allow them to be completely destroyed is because God knew alone the lineage that they was going to come forth. Amen. Hey, see, God can see the beginning and the end. Amen. But let me tell you something. They practically wiped them out, and they became cavemen. And so they cried out to God. And they said, God, we don't want our brother not to never exist again. Mm-hmm. He said, well, what I want you to do when you have a festival, he said, leave some of your virgins out there. And he said, I will allow the tribe of Benjamin to come out and take them as wives so that they will not be distinct. Mm. And that's how God allowed that to happen. But this is an abomination. It says a divination is a form of abomination would say, you know the truth.
Uh-huh.
But you don't want to do the truth. You're going to do the way you want it to do. And God is not pleased with that. Mm-hmm. So Halloween, you don't want your child to dress up like a man if there's a little girl.
Yeah.
And vice versa. And something else God brought to my attention.
Mm.
And this is awful. God showed this to me in a vision. Do you know there's some parents out there who want a daughter and all they've been having is boys? And they done took one of their sons and talked to that little boy and said, from now on, you are a girl. You know, it's okay. Dressing that child up in a dress You don't even have a choice because it's a little kid. Mm. And everybody thinking that it is a little girl when it's really a little boy. Woe unto you, thus saith the Lord. Amen. Yeah. Go ahead on.
My God, I'm completely stunned.
Oh, yeah.
By the things that are being said, because it's so true.
Yes, it is.
And it shows you a repeat behavior.
Yes, it does.
That they did this at Lot's house.
Right.
And now they're doing it in the book of Judges.
Right.
But the scripture that's amazing is when Nathaniel asks, can anything good come out of Nazareth?
Yes.
And Jesus Christ let him know, I came out of Nazareth.
Yes, yes.
And so through the Benjamites, you got Paul. Like you said, you have Mordecai, you have Queen Esther.
Mm-hmm.
And something good came out of that, those tribes.
Don't do
but
it.
The part I like is because they were concerned about their brother.
Yes, they were.
I want to ask you today, if you're concerned about your brother, you say you are.
Yeah.
You say, like Cain, am I my brother's keeper?
Right.
Yes, you are. You're responsible for your brethren.
Yeah.
That if you people all say that, I didn't have no daddy. Well, if you're a young man, then offer your assistance to your brother.
Right.
Don't despise them.
Mm-hmm.
Don't be jealous. But ask God to give you the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to help this vessel. Help them, help the young people on your block. If you don't have any siblings, don't wait in the shadows to steal the candy out their hand and beat them up and tap their bicycle and act in mischief.
Right.
But it's time for you to reach out and say, I am my brother's keeper.
Amen.
And so there's another passage in Isaiah, the 29th verse. In the 29th chapter, the 9th down to the 12th verse, it said, now stay in yourselves and wonder. Cry ye out and cry. They are drunken, but not with wine. They stagger, but not with strong drink. For the Lord hath poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep and hath closed your eyes, the prophets and your rulers, the seers had he covered. And the vision of all is become unto you as the words of a book that is sealed, which men deliver to one that is learned, saying,
yes.
Read this,
yes.
I pray thee. And he said, I cannot, for it is sealed.
Yes.
And the book is delivered to him that is not learned, saying, read this, I pray thee. And he said, I am not learned. Whether you are learned or unlearned,
yes.
If God has his hand against you,
yes.
There's nothing you could do. He said because of their disobedience, and we just read how people rebelled in the book of Deuteronomy and what's going to happen to you in the book of Judges, what happened. And for you that are, God has already convicted you. We have to get to that place. Everybody's not convicted at the same time.
Yes.
Because there was a time when we celebrated Halloween.
Amen.
But I want you to know that God said this particular time. He said, if you know and you don't do, to you is sin.
Right.
And it's an abomination.
Right.
He said, after a while, I'm going to close the eyes of the seer around
right,
you.
Right.
He said, the prophets that would prophesy to you, I'm going to stop their mouth. I'm going to put a book in front of the learned that's locked.
Right.
And then I'm going to put the same book in front of one that's unlearned.
Right.
And it's going to be open. In other words, they can't help you.
Right.
If you stray away from God in this particular season, God is trying to warn somebody that this is not business as usual.
Right.
But this is the day that God is convicting you to clean your act up, because you know not the day or the hour that God is going to require of you your soul.
Amen. And so, what we did at our church, we had Hallelujah Day on that day because the kids wanted to have their fun. So we had fun.
Yeah.
We had talent shows, and we had enough candy for them, so they didn't have to go out and be and partake of any of that. And when they walked in there, they dressed like Jesus, angel, the Virgin Mary, the apostles. Come on now. And we had talent shows, and we had so much fun. And to this day, all of my children, that's just what they do. Yeah. And so we don't let them go out and go door to door because things are too dangerous now. Yes. You don't know when somebody might snap. Look what happened in Vegas. That was just one man, like a normal man. And he was trying to take everybody out. And he done a pretty good job at that. So you don't want your kids knocking on anybody's door. You don't know what door did they knocking on. Yeah. See, about during my time, we could knock on people's doors. They would give us money and candy. Mm-hmm. We used to go to house parties. Just if you see anybody having a party, everybody can join in. It's not like that now. You try to go into somebody's house and you think you're going to be part of, you might get knocked back out. And they may come and invade you and rob you. So things have changed, it's more wicked now.
Yes.
So be wise as a serpent, but humble as a dove. Now, and Paul, him and Silas went to depart, and he went enter into this other place.
Yeah.
And he met a lady, and this lady was possessed. And it says, Acts chapter 16, verse 16. It said, and it came to pass as we went to prayer, a certain damsel possessed with a spirit of divination met us, which brought her master, which gained by smooth saying. In other words, she was a fortune teller. And that's another thing. Don't be believing in what the world say about you. I'm born in June, so I was supposed to be in a Gemini. And I remember one of the mothers of church, I said, I'm a Gemini, just as proud. She said, Gloria, and I'm supposed to be a Leo, and I ain't going to war like no lion. She said, you keep believing that, and you think you two people, that's the way you're going to act. And I said, Lord, I didn't even know. Don't let nobody tell you who you are. I tell you what God said about you. If you are born again, he said, you're fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous is my work. You're fearfully and wonderful made. And God said, you're the head and not the tail, and you're more than a conqueror. Amen. Yes, that's who you are. You're victorious in Christ Jesus. Jesus, amen. Yeah. So now let's go on. So this lady had a familiar spirit. And that's another thing. When you dress like these demonic things, you enhance the familiar spirits. And you stop saying prophetic words or saying things that you thinking is of God and it is not. Now, a familiar spirit is very cunning because it can see into the future and can say some things about you because it's a spiritual thing.
Yeah.
But beware. Yeah. Don't believe every winds of doctrine and every spirit. By the spirit. What? By the spirit.
Of God.
I'm telling you, because someone can be pretty real. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, you are a man of God. Now, that's another thing, how cunning it is. They can come to you. Oh, woman of God. Oh, well, I see blah, blah, blah. Yeah. And you're going to have all this money. You're going to marry this man. And this and that. That happened to me, too. And I married the wrong man. This lady come tell me, this man's going to call you on the phone. He called me on the phone. He's going to say this. And he did that. And I married this man. This was the most demonic man I ever seen. Well, most of them was. This right here take the cake. Well, the rest of them did, too. But this right had a little icing on it. And I believe it because she was a woman of God. You see what I'm saying? But no, you have to try. Don't let nobody tell you this foolishness. So anyway, kept going behind Paul. You serve the true and living God.
Yes.
And him being grieved, turned and said in verse 18 of Acts 16, and this did he many days, but you did it on and on and on. But Paul being grieved, turned and said unto the spirit, I command thee, in the name of Jesus Christ, to come out of her. And it came out the same hour. Look, I command in the name of Jesus for it to come out in the name of Jesus. And within the next hour, you're going
to
see some deliverance. Amen.
Glory to God.
Look, and the master of her got so mad, they threw him in jail, him and Silas. And which was all God's perfect plan. Amen. Because at midnight, they was in the cell.
Yeah.
And they began to pray so hard.
Hallelujah,
that the jail doors opened. Doors opened.
Thank you, Lord.
And he did that. Nobody leave. Yeah. But he was there for the captain, who his whole household got saved. He dropped on his knees, getting ready to kill himself. Hallelujah. And Paul said, don't kill yourself. God is telling you right now. You've been around this demonic stuff all this time as a demon of suicide.
Yes,
or maybe you fell short and came and got raped when you was a little kid and you're homosexual.
God,
you didn't know how to shake that thing off. And society's saying it's okay. Lord. No, it's not okay. But you can't be born again.
Hallelujah.
Except Jesus as your Lord and Savior. And he said, don't kill yourself. I'm telling you, don't kill yourself.
Yes.
There's hope with Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
Be saved. Accept the King and King, the Lord and Lord, because he's the great I am. He's all power.
Amen.
He is the higher power.
Thank
Amen.
You,
go ahead on, girl.
It's amazing.
Yes. Yes, it is.
I tell you, this is so exciting because there's hope.
Yes, it is.
See, that's the key. When you feel hopeless, then that means you don't know what the answer is. You're just exhausted.
Right.
You tried everything. Mm-hmm. But this word gives you hope.
Yes, it does.
It lets you know that all that you've tried, there is something that can help you.
Amen.
Today, as we point our finger at you, we're talking to you.
Yes.
We want you to know that God wants to save you.
Yes.
You have hope. Hope for tomorrow. I know people say, well, you don't know what just happened. You ain't paying attention to the news. I already know.
Amen.
If you've been reading this, you already know. You're not surprised.
Not surprised.
But there's a moment of clarity in your life that you must have. It'll bring you to yourself and cause you to know and understand that you have eternal life through Christ Jesus.
Amen.
It's with you. Mm-hmm. The scripture says that God was with talking to Moses.
Uh-huh.
And Moses got so excited with God. How many know that God is love?
Yes, he is.
He loves you with an everlasting love. Moses got so excited, he was kind of like Enoch.
Uh-huh.
And he began to walk with God where God had visited him. And he said, Lord, he said, God was talking to him and he said, I know you, Moses. And I know you have called you by name. He said, and I want to extend my grace to you.
Yes.
Moses says, that's so? Can I see you, God? He said, I want to see your glory. He said, you can't see me face to face. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to place you in the cleft of the rock. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, my God. I get so excited. He said, I'm a patient cleft of the rock. He said he put his hand on it.
Uh-huh.
Glory to God. And he passed by him. Hallelujah. Then he removed his hand and he said, you can see my hinder parts, but you cannot see my face and live. And then Jesus came right along and told Peter, he said, upon this rock, that same rock, I'm going to build my church. Hallelujah. The premises. He said, my hinder parts was the works that you do. I'm going to give you the keys to the kingdom.
Isn't that wonderful?
He told Paul, you can see my, Peter, you, he told Moses, you can see my hinder parts. And Jesus told Peter, you can, upon this rock, I'll build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against you because I'm giving you the keys. All that hinder parts are the keys to the kingdom.
Amen.
He said, whatever you bind on earth, I'll bind it in heaven.
Come on now.
Whatever you bind, you loose on earth, I'll loose it in heaven. Hallelujah. So Moses and Peter had the same experience. They were placed in the rock. Hallelujah. Place where God's hand is. In your churches, you having problems. Remember that God wants to put his hand in there.
Amen.
You got to let him put his hand in there. Things ain't working right because you got your hand in there. But if you move your hand and let the hand that God put on Moses. Y'all not listening to me. He said, if you let me, I'm going to put my hand on you.
Go ahead,
he said, I'm going to pass by you. You can see my back parts. I'm saying it again. Because when I read it, I was so excited. He said, Jesus told Peter the very same thing. I'm running out of time.
Well,
go ahead,
run
Pastor.
Out of time. Well, anyway, the true trick or treat was this.
Thank you,
was
love.
When Judith betrayed Jesus with a kiss.
Yes, Lord.
Sold him out for 30 pieces of silver.
My God.
He got on that cross, and
thank
they thought Jesus. He was dead. They thought he had him. The devil thought
yes,
that was the end
yes,
of him.
Yes, Lord.
But the treat was he rose again. Huh?
You've been listening to Pastor Gloria, the prayer warrior of our Lord, our Righteousness House of Prayer. For more information or prayer, call 310-418-8189. 310-418-8189.